This machine, Linotype, was invented by a man called Ottmar Megenthaler, who was a German. He lived in America and he invented this machine in 1885. And it rapidly became a very important machine for the printing industry. And within 10 years, it had become the main typesetting machine in newspapers in the United States. And it spread worldwide to the UK and to Europe and to Ireland. Ireland, around about the year 1900, had the first Linotype machines. This machine, an operator will get the copy, place the copy on the tray, and each key there will bring down a mat. It sets the line in there, the space bands create the space, and the line is set in the machine and comes out, it's ejected out there. And an article can be a short article, a long article, 10 pars, 20 pars, or a big long article. And the machine itself recycles everything. Everything is recycled. The mattresses, the space bands are going in and back and around. The whole thing is recycling all the time. And when the metal comes out and the metal is used, that also is melted down again at the end of the printing process. When the type was set by the operator, the Linotype operator's role in setting the type ended there. He brought the type over to a random, which was a central area in the case room where all the type came together. It was put on a galley, proofed on an inking press, and sent into the reading room for checking. If there were any errors in it, corrected proof was sent out for one or two, whatever, lines. There might be no errors, but there might be an error or two that had to be corrected. Once that was done, then it was ready to go into the page. This is a newspaper page, an old technology, hot metal newspaper page. And I'm going to make a couple of little adjustments. The first edition has already been printed. This is now the second edition. So there are a couple of little alterations that we're going to make. One of them, I'm going to change this line here. Replace it with that line. And we have another story here, which replaces this story for this edition. So I take out this type and hold it to one side and replace it with the type that has just been set on the Linotype machine. And that's dropped in, and the page is then tightened up, and once that's done, it's prepared for the stereo. This is the second edition of the paper, now ready to go.